In this video, we will review the major joints of the body and demonstrate the motions that occur at these joints. Learning these directional terms will not only help you understand movement within the skeletal system, but also will help you when you get to the muscular system, because these same terms will be used to describe the actions associated with skeletal muscles. The first set of joints to consider are the spinal or vertebral joints. Movement in the spine occurs mainly at the posterior facet joints, which are diarthrodial synovial joints, with a slight amount of movement also occurring at the amphiarthrotic cartilaginous joints located between the vertebral bodies and the intervertebral discs. Starting at the cervical spine, the movements include flexion at the neck, extension at the neck, and continuing in the direction of extension but past the neutral anatomical position, we have hyperextension of the cervical spine. Notice how these movements, flexion, extension, hyperextension, occur along a sagittal plane. We also have left lateral flexion and right lateral flexion of the cervical spine, which occur in the coronal or frontal plane. And lastly, left rotation of the cervical spine and right rotation of the cervical spine. The same movements occur in the lumbar spine. Flexion of the lumbar spine, extension of the lumbar spine, and hyperextension. Left lateral flexion and right lateral flexion of the lumbar spine. Left rotation and right rotation of the lumbar spine. Notice that the thoracic spine is also moving in the same directions, but with a lesser degree of movement due to the rib cage limiting mobility. The shoulder joint, or glenohumeral joint, is a ball and socket type of synovial joint between the head of the humerus and the glenoid fossa of the scapula. Movement at the shoulder joint includes flexion at the shoulder in a forward or anterior direction, extension at the shoulder in a posterior direction, and past the neutral anatomical position into hyperextension. Movement of the humerus away from the midline of the body is called abduction, and towards the midline of the body is adduction. Lastly, the shoulder can do internal rotation, which can also be called medial rotation, as well as external rotation, which can also be called lateral rotation. The hip joint is similar in structure to the shoulder joint. Notice how the head of the femur forms a ball and socket joint with the acetabulum of the coxal bone, much like the humerus does with the scapula. This means that the same directional movements that occur at the shoulder joint will also occur at the hip joint. Flexion at the hip, extension at the hip, and hyperextension at the hip. Abduction at the hip, adduction, internal rotation or medial rotation, and external rotation or lateral rotation of the hip. The elbow joint is between the distal humerus and the proximal radius and ulna, and is capable of flexion and extension. Flexion at the elbow, extension at the elbow. Note that hyperextension is not normally possible because of the bony structure of the elbow joint. Similarly, in the lower extremity, the knee joint has the capability of moving into flexion and extension. Flexion at the knee, extension at the knee. However, flexion at the knee occurs as the distal leg moves in a posterior direction, whereas during flexion of the elbow, the forearm moves in an anterior direction. In the upper extremity, note that there is an extra synovial joint in the forearm between the head of the radius and the proximal ulna. There is no comparable joint in the lower extremity. This proximal radio-ulnar joint allows for a rotational movement to happen at the forearm. This movement is called pronation, as the radius crosses the ulna and the palm faces in a posterior direction, and supination, when the palm of the hand faces anteriorly. If the elbow is in a flex position, then we see the palm turn downward during pronation of the forearm and the palm upward in supination. Some students like to remember supination is like holding a bowl of soup. Multiple carpal bones of the wrist, along with the distal radius and ulna, play a part in wrist movement, which allows the wrist to move into flexion at the wrist, extension at the wrist, and hyperextension the wrist. Abduction of the wrist can also be called radial deviation, and adduction of the wrist, which can also be called ulna deviation. Joints of the fingers can move into flexion of the fingers, extension of the fingers, abduction, and adduction. These same movements can also occur at the toes. Additionally, the thumb or pollex can do a movement known as opposition. Movement at the ankle joint, the joint located between the medial malleolus of the tibia, the lateral malleolus of the fibula, and the talus bone, includes dorsiflexion at the ankle, which is an upward movement of the foot towards the leg, and plantar flexion at the ankle, a downward movement of the foot. If we also include movements of the tarsal bones, then the foot can also move into inversion of the foot and eversion of the foot. In the skull, the only freely movable synovial joints are the temporomandibular joints. Movements include depression of the mandible, elevation of the mandible, protraction of the mandible, and retraction of the mandible. There is also a side-to-side movement that is sometimes referred to as lateral deviation of the mandible. Lastly, I want to go over some movements that occur at the scapula. Officially, the scapula does not form a true joint with the thorax. It only articulates with the clavicle and the humerus. But the scapula is free to glide and move over the thorax due to the activity of many muscles that you will eventually learn. So, when describing movements associated with the scapula, you'll call the movements elevation of the scapula, depression of the scapula, protraction of the scapula, or retraction of the scapula. Hopefully this video has helped you get a better understanding of how to correctly name the movements that occur at the different joints of the body. Thanks for watching, and let your instructor know if you have any questions.